it was reported this morning by Iran's chief nuclear negotiator that their uranium enrichment, which under the JCPOA, that's the Iran agreement, was supposed to be at 5%. That's for medical use, generating power. Was the reports months ago, a couple months ago, that it was 20%, which sent off alarm bells. Well, now you're at a 5 alarm because their negotiator's saying they're at 60%.
The reason that the JCPOA, as flawed as it was, limited them to 5% enriched uranium is because at 5%, that you can do all of your civilian power work, your medical research and tests, all of that is done at the 5% level. There is really no use for any uranium above 5% for civilian or medical power purposes.
You were the ambassador to Germany. Germany has been a big financial partner with Iran on finances here. What would be the reaction of, I would think they would be outraged, but I don't get that. I don't see that.
Well, the Europeans have said publicly multiple times and in written form that they are with us on trying to reach the goal of denying Iran a nuclear weapon. That's been clear. We've always said that we have different tactics on how to get there. Well, this is now evidence that the Europeans should be very upset that for the last several years, big surprise, Iran has been lying to us about centrifuges and enrichment. Two issues of incredible concern.
Yep.
Now, I'd like to know, did John Kerry know that they were doing this? Was there a shadow campaign? And lastly, our U.S. ambassador to the U.N. should be calling an emergency Security Council meeting today on this news.
Last week, I read a report by the Nuclear Arms Association in which they said at the 20% level, as opposed to 5%, that the breakout time, the time they can go from today to a bomb, had dropped to a matter of months. That was at 20%. Now it's going to 60%. I mean, the breakout time is getting shorter and shorter.
This announcement of an increase to 60% enrichment of uranium was not made during the Trump administration. It was made during the Biden administration, and it's a test. It's just to see how far Joe Biden is going to go. And the response from Washington has been lukewarm to nothing. We're going to still open the door to negotiations. You cannot negotiate with the government of Iran. These are not negotiable people. These are terrorists. They would never have done this under President Trump. They would not have dared to do this because they know that the iron fist of the United States would have come down. But now they do it with impunity. And so who has to come to the rescue? Israel.
The other thing, Jay, that makes this even more alarming. For the last 5 or 6 years, Iran has been violating UN resolutions that forbid them from the research and development of ballistic missiles. They have always ignored that with impunity, so that when you take their capability of producing a bomb in a matter of months and combine that with their ballistic missile program, which is highly advanced now, and they have a larger missile arsenal than any country in the Middle East, including Israel, you take that missile technology and the nuclear weapon idea, it is extremely grave and alarming.
I think if you look at this from a rational, analytical perspective, there is no reason for the United States to resume negotiations with the Iranians. But it's important to keep in mind some background. Iran has always been pushing against a wide open door with respect to negotiations with Western powers. Iran has frequently sought to exploit the fecklessness of Western powers and their willingness to put Israel at risk.
It was actually written last week, but released by ODNI this morning, that says they believe that Iran is not seeking a nuclear weapon. It says, I quote, "We continue to assess that Iran is not currently undertaking the key nuclear weapons development activities that we judge would be necessary to produce a nuclear device."
Here's the problem. 90%, it's a weapon. Let me tell you what the uses are at 60%. Getting ready to be a weapon. Under the so-called JCPOA, the Iran nuclear deal, it was not supposed to be over 5%. And the United States pulled out of that deal, but the European countries were still in it. And this tells you exactly what the Iranians are thinking about this the whole time.